WorkOS User Management makes it easy for users to connect to your apps with a wide range of authentication strategies. And it does so without requiring you to give up control of your user objects. In fact, the only thing that's required for a valid user object in WorkOS is an email address. Let's dive into the WorkOS Users endpoint. On my screen now are a number of client libraries and SDKs that are language specific. Today, we'll go right to the source and use HTTP requests. And note that because I'm logged in, I automatically get my staging token in all of these examples. Today, we're focusing on user management, specifically the user's object. I like to start with the list because it's the most simple request to make. Copy the user's list requests and create a new postman request. Paste the URL and the headers will automatically get added to this request in the headers section. We authenticated and got an empty user list object. Now we can add to our users by making a post request to the same URL. Change this to post and add some form data. Here we'll use raw JSON. Opening up the create user docs, we see the shape of data we need to send along and that email is the only required field. So let's create a new user with just an email. Email hi@chan.dev and send it. We get a 201 status code saying that the object was created. And while it's missing a handful of details, we do have a new user ID. We can get records by submitting a get request to user management users ID. Let's duplicate users again, add our ID to the URL and get our user record. At our users endpoint, we can also update records. Looking at the docs, we do this through a put request. Change this to put, add some request data. Again, raw JSON. And we can provide fields like first name, last name, and email verification status. Let's send this to get a new updated user record. Now, last but not least, we can do one last thing at this user ID endpoint, and that is to delete records. Send that, and our user record is deleted, which we can verify by going to users and seeing again the empty list. Okay, so that's how you create, read, update, and destroy user records. Let's take a look at lists. And for that, I've pre-populated a few user objects. Now, when I request my list of users, I see a full list of user objects. We have one for John Lennon, Paul McCartney, so on and so forth. We can limit our search with a number of parameters. So if we know the exact email that we want for a user record, we can send that along with the request, getting a list of one record. We can also limit the number of results with the limit parameter. Let's limit this to 4, and to get the original Beatles, also change the order to ascending. And we see John, Paul, George, and Ringo. Finally, we have these before and after options that we can use to get records after a certain index. So to get the next records, we just need to say after and provide the last user ID from the previous request. Now we have Pete Best, Stuart Sutcliffe, and so forth, with new options for moving forward and backwards in the index. So that's about all you need to know to get started with user management inside of WorkOS. Jumping off points from here, I think that you should look into identities and how they are linked together, and also organizations, how you can assign and remove people to and from organizations. That's it for now. Tell us what you'd like to learn next in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.